Thank you for coming.
I'd like to briefly introduce what we're going to do today. Today, we're here for Women in Motion.
So today, this is a very important talk for Kering. We'd like to talk about what women in cinema can play the role, their influence. We are very pleased to take part in this event because this subject in Europe is a very researched and talked, discussed, even in America. And now China is taking part in this talk. So we can all explore and talk about this subject, and women in cinema can play a better role. This subject takes us to introduce who are present here. I'm Angelica Chung. I'm Director Chief for Vogue China. In China, this magazine, through fashion and culture, talk about women and their influence, their attitude. And also, we introduced these past years Vogue film. Through short feature films, we can associate fashion and women and also men, and also talk about modern women's attitude and the culture. Through this item, we have a cooperation with stars, actors, actresses, and directors, and also short movies directors. Wen Ye, we are also talking about how to work together. So here, for directors, for films, we can have more knowledge and understanding on this topic. That's why we are here today. Here we have on my left, Chun Chun, Chris Lee. She is a singer, actress, dancer. She has many talents. And since her start beginning, she has been always very modest in her work or her attitude or her behavior and contact with people. She has always kept to being herself. And she also developed and progressed with the epoch. We know each other very much, so we can talk to him. Tao, he is very young. Actually, a few months ago when I met him in my office, the first impression he gave me was, wow, another new generation. He's very confident. He has his own viewpoints, and he is blunt. So I was not prepared, and I was impressed. Oh, he's so direct and frank. So I think that's the new generation. And today, I hope that Tao will talk off his head and also be frank. And further, Wen Yan, Vivian Chu, my very good friend, dear friend. I respect her as a director of films. She's really working hard and pay attention to her work for images and the post work on the film. And she's very serious. We have many common points. Her latest movie, Angels Wear White, has been awarded and is also on a topic with girls. So it's very suited to our topic today. Now, when Kering talked about this subject matter, we also discussed about this topic. My first reaction, like you, It's like women in this industry, at least in China, has not been treated unevenly or unfairly. Like in the fashion world, many people ask me this subject matter, and I always think of a good actor or bad actor, good designer or bad designer. I never think about the status of women in this industry. So maybe because the people working with us are all very open and very kind, so I did my research. And I wanted to know, I have many figures, I'm not going to tell them here very simply. The Golden Award in Hong Kong has been celebrated for 87 times, and the best director, a woman best director, has always been An Hui, only 6 times awarded for women. And the Golden Horse Festival in Taiwan, only 6 directors awarded for women. And also in China, the Association of Film Directors are 24 members. 7% are women. So if we don't see the figures, we don't know. But when we look at the figures, we can see that women in the cinema, in the film industry, has very little part or very little proportion percentage. So I can talk with Wei Yan, Vivian Chu. She's so successful. She must have her own thoughts, viewpoints on this matter. How come the percentage of women in the cinema industry in China is so little? Actually, I don't have the answer. I only can guess. This figure, I only knew about it these in past years, very recently. I think it's all societal phenomenon. Women in general have to take upon herself the family. So at some point, when she reaches a certain age, she has to make a choice, a decision. So very often at a certain age, women choose to be behind the scene and to be in the family and let the place to men. For jobs are very challenging, people can say, oh, it's too tiring for a woman, so you don't do it. And very, not very openly, they hint that you should choose for something easier, less tiring. So maybe with the time, women think that they can choose jobs less challenging, and we can see our role models being women are less. When we talk about big directors, big film directors, they're all men. So when you wanted to be a director, have you told yourself that you're a woman, so you have less chances? Have you ever thought about it? Yes, maybe I'm an exception because since my childhood I have not found myself very grown. So in my work, many people say film director is very tiring. It's a very tiring job. So you don't choose to do this. Can you do something else? Many people tell me that. But I think it's really up to you. If you are strong enough, you have a strong mind, nothing is a problem. When you think it's tiring, and people say being director is tiring, what is tiring? Tiring because creation is not easy. You have to think about something emotional in the deep in your heart, so you can spend a lot of time trying to find the sensation, this feeling. Then you have to look for investors, producers, and it's very long, and you have to work for with more than 100 people. Yes, it's not only a creation, right? It's also how to manage. Yes, it's not like painting or writing. You can be alone, you can complete a work alone, but a film is very different. It's multidisciplinary. So you have to also have good contact, yes. Yes, I have to think about many, many things. Yes, talking about film directors being very tired. You are actors. Have you ever thought about being a director? Chris says, yes, I've been thinking about it. It's because I'm growing up, and I have, during this time, many, many things I want to express. I have my own values, viewpoints, and film is a very multidisciplinary. It's a medium. You have an idea? Actually, now I'm only on the stage of preparation. For a film director, this is not a technical work. You have to prepare yourself, you have to have experience, you have to be mature enough. It's not a unilateral work, it's quite complex. Among so many directors, men or women, are there someone who can inspire you? Yes, I saw a movie on a female topic shot by a woman director. The film is Frida, and I really like this artist. Sometimes I tell myself, maybe I cannot do as much as she did. She's so passionate. She really lived her life, but it was all very good expressed in the film. Tao, you are a singer, you are actor and dancer, and so you also played in many soap operas. Can you now tell us your feelings? Because your role was very difficult, right? With many movements. I'm not thinking about becoming a film director, but I want to concentrate myself on acting, on works. When I have many works, I can maybe think one day about becoming a film director, but I'm not really suited. Why? Because I'm still an actor. I want to be first a good actor. And before doing very, very completely what I do, I don't think about anything else. And you think also film director is not easy, right? Yes. I had a man director for my film. Sorry, I'm not going to talk about this here. Okay, so Vivian, women directors compared to men directors facing to societal subjects, do they have different angles of reflection and of viewpoints? Because for fashion designers, be them women or men, they all design for women, right? But what about in the cinema? I think certainly they have different reflections and viewpoints, but it's not that easy. You can't say that women directors have these kind of reactions and the men directors have others. When it's a very good director, he or she reflects and respects women in their work, in their film. Every person should have his or her own opinion, personality. We cannot generalize. In general, we don't want to have an etiquette. Because you're a woman director, so your film is like this. We should only concentrate on the movie director, not because she's a woman, that she's different, but because she's a film director. This is the job. So the result in the film should be express how you feel, your viewpoint. Yes, indeed, very often it's linked to the education that you receive. In main cities, in mega cities, men and women are very alike. When we were a child, we went to school just like boys, no problem. We had all equal education. But in far behind the regions, areas, and the backward areas, girls are maybe less at school. And they might have talents, but they don't have the opportunity to express themselves. So when you were shooting Angels Wear White, you went to a very far village in the south of China. So when you went to that area, and lived there for a certain period of time, what did you think about the girls' conditions there? Actually, I found my two main characters, two girls, very young. I interviewed more than 1,000 girls. They were all very smart, very clever. But when they are 12 or 13 years old, they are very candid, and I met 15 and 16 years old girls. They were not that candid. They had a certain pattern of acting, and also made me think that our education may be formatted these girls. Whereas in cities, girls have a more open mind and more opportunities to touch upon new things. So in the process of preparing the film, I think all children are fine, but they should be directed and supported and oriented. We should not give them a pattern or a road to follow. Because you're a girl, you should be like that and not like this. Yes, indeed, in education, there are many models and many formats, and children cannot listen to themselves, to their heart, so they don't have their own way to express themselves. Yes, indeed, it is a very important point. I was thinking it's this for film directors, but there are many professions in a film. For actors, for example, when I received the topic of today, I was thinking about actors. If we talk about Chinese actors, actresses, very famous in the world, that's Gong Li, first of all, Zhang Ziyi, Zhang Manyi, Maggie Chong, she's not starring in many movies now. But you see, when we can talk about Chinese actors' names, they're all women. And otherwise, from Hong Kong, Liang Chaowei, Tony Chong, and Zhou Renfa. But I was thinking, for example, Chris, you played in many films, you were working with actors and actresses. Do you think that actors in China or in the international area, being an actress, is it an advantage? Actually, I starred in only a few movies, maximum five, I think, because I'm a singer at the beginning, and cinema is a new world, a new window opened to me. And when I joined acting, I actually developed potentials I didn't even know about myself. It's a new world, and during this process, I worked with many very good actors and actresses. I think that female characters, especially at a certain age,
maybe the space that the actress can have is a little, is narrower, and there are formats for an aged actress. Whereas I think we can have more different expressions for them. So when you choose a part in a movie, do you think because the part is more suited to your character? Yes, sometimes it's the film director who thinks that Chris is more for this role and not for that role. And when I know myself better how to act and can think about how to act and to express myself, I can do more. Yes, a few actors think how to act better, a certain kind of role, but others can play any role. Yes, I really think and wish that a role when it's proposed to me can be different from the past. Yes, I also think that when acting, like in every profession, you need to have a professional experience. It's not like Zhang Ziyi. When she debuted, she was excellent already. Whereas others have to become better and better, can always progress and have experience. When an actor is 30 or 40 years old, is mature enough, but very often we think that mature actresses have very little roles suited to themselves, very few choices. That's why people want to look younger and try to act younger. I sometimes say, you see, Catherine Deneuve, they can age gracefully. Actually, it's not to appear younger. It's if I don't appear younger, I have very, very little choices and very little parts proposed to me. And I was quite impressed, and also this made me think, is this a phenomenon in China or is it everywhere? I think it's more serious in China, because in Hollywood, we can see very often, like recently, there are three screen boards. Frances McDormand, she's middle-aged, and she's not very beautiful, and she won the best actress at Oscars. So in Western cinema, there are many roles written for aged women, whereas in China, there are very, very few. When I was a producer, I was talking with producers and investors, and they said, oh, the role in your script is 35, can you change it into a 25? Years old women character. So it's really not against the women, but when a woman is 30 or 40, they become less beautiful, or because Chinese people have only a unilateral perception of beauty, and this unilateral perception is only the youth, the young beauty. So a woman film director should make efforts to change the mind. Tao, you're so young, so it's maybe it's not very easy to reply to this question. For such a young man that you are, when you look at mature actresses, very excellent actresses, and you see them aging, what do you think? Do you find they have to be themselves? Yes, they should be themselves and do what they like and insist on doing what they like. In many cases,
girls don't have their destination or objective. Like Vivian said, girls think that they should be in the family, they should work on a less tiring job, etc. Otherwise, I think women have to have a profession and insist on doing what they like. Yes, I talk about younger women. And now that you are in the cinema industry, you are acting, do you think it's for your interest or because for your profession? It's for my dream. Actually, last time you talked a lot. How come today you're shy? Because this is a very official interview. I'm not really adapted. I'm not used to it. I feel quite embarrassed and nervous. Yes, I remember you can act, you can have kung fu movements, you can sing, you can dance. Do you have such a role? Anyway, I'll persevere. No matter how tough it is, I have to make efforts. Yes, I remember you told me you saw many, many movies. Do you have any role or character which impressed you or a film which impressed you the most? Actor or actresses? For me, it's Jackie Chan, yes, definitely. Why? Because he's my master. And I was a child already, and I watched his movie. I grew up watching his movies. When I was a child, I studied martial arts. He was my idol, and when I grew up, I met my idol and learned from him. So I wanted to really continue on this path. Yes, talking about actresses, I'd like to ask you, in many films, there's also a problem for actresses. When I talked with them, we all find they are like a decoration in a film. They don't have a real role written for them. Just to be beautiful in a film, it's enough. And Tao, if you have your word to say, what do you think? You want a beautiful actress to play with you or what? If I have the choice, I can choose someone that is very simple. I don't know how to say it. No, you're talking fine. Yes, because there are actresses who are very proud and they try to be the latest on the set. And this is wrong. This is wrong. If I am in a set, in a cast, I don't want to be late because I'm professional. And I wish that the actress in front of me is also very professional so I can learn from her. I want to play with someone like this. Be it actor or actress.
Oh,
actually, you are behaving like Tao now because you are really frank. Yes, I think for film directors, they all want a professional attitude for actor and actress. You are idols, you are young, and really this discussion is online very often. You are young, you just joined the film industry, and you are so firm and frank. It's really welcome. Chris has always been very professional, right? You have very good reputation. Yes, indeed. So you have always had your own personality, be it for your concerts or films. So do you think women characters or roles in Chinese movies, are they still for decoration or they are moving ahead? Do you have this sensation?
Yes,
actually the space is narrower for women, especially roles written for them. And also our beauty standard is formatted. Actually, an actor is at the service of the role, the part. So we should choose an actor for the role to see whether he or she is suited. So let's talk about creation. Because creation itself has not a role for women or written for women. So there's no much choice. I was thinking, which one comes first? For example, from the director's point of view, for an actress, is it possible that this person gives a soul to the character, to the role? Yes, on the set, the film director has the last word to say. So actor and actresses have a little room for their own choice to express. If the director doesn't have a role for a woman in death, he or she can only ask the actress to just be beautiful. Even if the actress wants to do more, the director says, no, no, just do this and it's quite enough. So when you write a screenplay, you should already give body to a role, a feminine role, or just to give it a plain role. I know a little bit, but I think the public is curious. You have two girls, very young characters in your movie, so there's so good, they were so good. So how did you choose them when you interviewed more than 1,000 people? They are so beautiful. When you chose them, you just want them to be beautiful? No, actually, Xiaomi, this character played by Wen Qi, I asked to have a good personality more than a good face. That was my standard when I wanted to choose. Because this girl should be very stubborn, very has a strong personality. And Zhao Wen, the other character, should be beautiful because of the story. But when I was choosing, I was not only choosing a graceful face. The person has to have a character, a personality as well, because she's going to be a victim. But because she's stubborn and she wants to go ahead in the play, in the story, in the film, she was not only a poor girl victim. Actually, these are very good examples because they are talented, have a big potential, and they met you, met this good movie, this good story. So since early age, early stage, they can express themselves. That's why the result was excellent. But many people don't have this opportunity. Maybe very late in their career, they can really have a good role which can speak to you. It's really rare. It's really rare. Therefore, we all have to make efforts. I'd like to ask,
for
example, for you, which are the subject matters that interest you? Because we talked about directors, actors, actresses. We still have to have a good topic, because a topic can reflect the person's feelings on culture, on societal phenomena. Because in Chinese movies, we have many themes of epoch, of past history, whereas movies on the modern society, there are less, right? Yes, compared to the past stories, features. There are less modern society movies. When I started, they said, oh, you're a woman director, so just shoot a comedy. Comedy with a love story. We are in a modern society, but our humanity has not changed. We are just like people in the past. We have the same feelings facing the society, facing phenomena. But there are so limited choice, either a love story, either a comedy, or a historic story. Your films have always been welcomed everywhere because you choose a very modern and topic. So it may be an example to encourage other people. It's like Cannes, like other festivals, can give a space and a room of expression to many people.
Tao,
do you have
topics,
subject matters that you can propose? Don't stare at me. Don't stare at me. Do you have any subject matter that can be explored?
除了Jackie Chan的电影，还有什么你觉得你喜欢看的？
Besides Jackie Chan, besides Kung Fu, as a public observer, what can you propose?
Oh,
I'm a viewer of fantastic movies of science fiction. For example, two persons in a flying ship and can be awakened and also found themselves dead. I forgot the name. Ah, it's gravity. Someone said, yeah, it's gravity. Yes, this kind, this genre is really what I like. So you are very curious of the outer space because you can't see it by your own eyes. You can see it through a film. Yes, things we cannot have, we cannot see, we cannot touch. We go to read a book or watch a movie. Chris, what can you propose to people in the industry to think about? I like more literary subject matters, more realistic. For example, the true life, the true personality, human side, that's what interests me.
其实呢, 现在呢, yes,
women
emotion,
就是觉得这个可能在好莱坞啊，就是觉得女性呢，全员演员啊，女导演啊，整个的产业就是什么新高全员啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演啊，女导演 understood.
What
can I say? I have a friend in the advertisement. She is a director, design and creation director. So when she talks with investors, she and her colleagues, two other women, when they are only women to talk about a 10 million project, she cannot achieve and conclude the contract, whereas she takes a male assistant, she can conclude. So it's really very,
very
good example. Maybe she's not the only example. Many, in many cases, we can see, even in Western world, women directors have a smaller budget than male directors moving. So this is comparable to the example I just quoted, because people think that a woman director cannot shoot a big production. A woman director can shoot a movie with a smaller budget.
You
don't have a problem in remuneration, right?
开玩笑,
you must say it's a joke. It's a joke.
是,
但是我身边确实有这种, 就是,
but I see
我一般拍戏的时候,
with other people.
我拍戏的时候, 我感同身受,
when I act, in a film, I can feel that I've never learned anything from a star. I've learned things from a very, very good actor or a very, very good actress, but who are not very famous. I can learn really a lot from them. Unfortunately, they're not famous, they don't earn a lot. Unfortunately, this is what I've been experiencing. Because every time I talk with them, I'm so sad. I feel so sad. Because they're excellent, but they don't have the opportunity to become a star. Yes, you have met people like this.
Yes.
Today, we have been
过后呢, 还可以继续延展, 但是总结一下, 说到中国的这个女性的电影人的这个问题, 其实总的来讲, 大家还是挺惊喜的, 是吧? 没有觉得这个事情特别特别严重, 但是呢, 还是有一些我们可以推动的地方, 从一方面就是希望对于女孩子, 从小的教育, 对吧? 更加的推动, 更加让女孩子很小, 不管她, 生长在中国的哪个地方, 那都知道自己呢, 是有
可能通过教育多提高多了解世界，能够有到找到自己的梦想，然后有这个自己的这个勇气，就这个教育其实做到这一点，就可以教给这个年轻人向前走。然后第二个呢，就是希望。 Moreover,
这个创作的这个团体是吧，大概社会呢可以创作更多的。
多样化一些丰富的一些题材和这个电影题材，因为我觉得它很丰富，有个性，有内涵的思想，有很好的这个世界的理解的这种女性的角色本身，那对观众、对整个社会的女性的观众都会带来更好的。
更加的有意义，精彩一些。当然，对于女性的从业者电影从业者，那机会就更多。还有呢，就是可能我觉得我们电影人，我算沾了一点点边的啊，自称也是电影人，但是有点边的。就是我觉得我们自己呢，也应该更积极，对吧？主要是跟你说，他们两个很积极，你也很积极。我们都应该很积极的，就是说不要去抱怨太多。
更加的以积极的心态来多参与，
不要只是在边上去评论、
Don't be just an outsider to complain and to criticize. We have to take part, to join, to be involved, and also be blunt and brave to find a breakthrough. Because only if we have good work, a masterpiece to impress, we can make difference. We can invite more people to join in working for women. We really think that in recent years we have been doing fine, and we expect your next movie, Vivian, and we hope with TAO we will have a very good progress in every field and be very realistic and professional. And Chris, we really wish you one day to become a film director. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you. 憋啥？哦哟！